Cooking with Mr. LP. And guess what? I got this new cookbook
called Dynamite Chicken by Tyler Cord.
And I love it. I got it at a local store in New Hope. And we're going to head to the kitchen and create the first recipe. Well, it might not be the first recipe in the book, but it is right here. And it's broiled chicken thighs with plum tomatoes and garlic. I'm so excited. It looks delicious and sounds great. So let's get to the kitchen and we'll start cooking. Okay, my hands are washed and I'm ready to go. Got my apron, put it on, and first thing we're gonna do is get the olive oil and the salt. Remember, we're making broiled chicken thighs with plum tomatoes and garlic. The oven is heated to 400 degrees, and I'm gonna do this in the roasting pan with the olive oil. So it says a teaspoon and a half of salt and some olive oil. So I'm gonna put my chicken pans, it says skin side down, but I'm gonna mix them up first. Just wanna roast them so they're not too dark. So we got olive oil, it says like 2 teaspoons, so I love olive oil, so I'm just gonna slather it on. Teaspoon and a half of salt, using some sea salt. That's about a teaspoon right there. Get rid of the rest. All right, we're just gonna mix them up a little bit. All right, we're gonna place them skin side down. Get them ready to roast. While they're roasting, I'm gonna get the plum tomatoes ready. Just wanna spread them out so they cook evenly. All right, and here we go, right in the oven. Set the timer, 45 minutes. Let's get to the plum tomatoes. All right, now we're gonna smash our garlic cloves and half our plum tomatoes. It says 6 plum tomatoes. I'm gonna use 7 because it's my lucky number. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, we're just gonna half them lengthwise. Now we're gonna smash some garlic cloves. Ready? So that's how we get the skin off. We're gonna crack them open. And it calls for 6. Oh, sorry, it calls for 10. So, but these are pretty big. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna smash them. So with my knife, I smash. Look how nice it evenly gets peeled. And you get that whole peel off. So I'm gonna do that with all of them. I like to cut this little stem off. Now we're getting the rest of the ingredients together. So I've got my smashed garlic all ready to go. I've got our half Roma tomatoes. Other ingredients we're gonna need are fish sauce and some white wine vinegar. All right, we're gonna serve it with some crusty bread and over some sauteed spinach. I'll get to that a little bit. Now we don't wanna forget the thyme, that also goes on top of that. And we're just waiting for the chicken another 35 minutes or so, and then I'll bring it out and mix it all together. And if you could, now's the time. Don't forget to like and subscribe so that you can get more videos. I don't make them that often. I don't want to inundate your mailbox, but I get some inspiration every now and then, like the new cookbook. All right, so like and subscribe right now. So while the chicken's roasting in the oven, I'm gonna saute the spinach and put it to the side because we don't need it hot, we just need it nice sauteed spinach. So I'm gonna crank up the burner and get this pan fired up. So I'm gonna use a little bit of olive oil. And about a half a tablespoon of butter. I like it a little rich. And then you already saw me smash the garlic. Some
minced garlic from the jar. I love garlic, especially my spinach. Putting in a full chunk, tablespoon. That's gonna get hot. We want it hot, and then we'll saute our spinach. All right, now I'm just gonna take this whole container of spinach, and it's a good 16 ounces, but it's packed in there. So wait till you see how this sautés down. So I'm gonna throw it in. Put the lid on for a few seconds, and then turn it over. Wait till you see how it shrinks. Look, stuff up and sauté it around now. Can't wait for a bigger Le Creuset pot. Then it won't all fall out, I guess. I'm gonna pick it up with some of the garlic. Pick it up, pick it up. There it is. You can see the garlic coming to the top. Keep it going, keep it going. A little salt. And we've got, I don't know, maybe four small helpings of spinach. Now I'm going to turn it off and check it out. It's all wilted. Mix the garlic, get that garlic in there, get the salt. There you go. Check it out. 16 ounces of spinach, four small servings for two large. I'm going to set that aside and wait for the chicken. If you're watching, Gideon, the shout out to you. So I'm still using this awesome kitchen pot holder. All right, it's time for the chicken to come out. It looks very brown, but not too brown. All right, look at all those juices, awesome. We're gonna, we're gonna use those juices to mix with the tomatoes. In the meantime, I'm going to set the oven on broil for high. So we're gonna mix in the tomatoes and the garlic. I'm gonna reposition everything. Lots of garlic. Look at that, it looks really good. But we want to get some of that juice in the tomatoes. So I'm just gonna mix it up a little bit right here in the pan. So that's the good thing about this recipe. Only one pan. So far. Mm-hmm. I've got some dishes and anything. Anyway, let's get these all juiced up here. Because you're gonna turn up the tomatoes and put them back in the oven. One of the greatest things about this recipe is the thyme. So we want to put some thyme sprigs, and it calls for, I think, 12, on top of the tomatoes. Time. We want the thyme to get charred. The thyme, it says, is going to disintegrate. So we're gonna put it on top. All the sprigs. Oh, the thyme is just gonna be amazing. It's beautiful. It's gonna go in the oven and broil right in the middle until they get nice and brown. All right. 4 to 8 minutes. All right, we're gonna check the chicken. All right, just beautifully charred. Oh my goodness, it looks amazing. Now I have to separate out the chicken and the tomatoes. So the chicken is going to go on a plate. Just rest for a little bit. Thyme, we're just gonna remove if there's any that aren't disintegrated. And then we're going to put tomatoes and the garlic in a bowl. Because now we're gonna add the last finishing touches. Look at that. It's great. Juicy and soft. Now we're gonna add to our sauce, we're gonna add the tablespoon of white wine vinegar. And a teaspoon of fish sauce.
Now, the fish sauce is pretty salty, so I'm not gonna add the extra salt that it calls for. So we're gonna mix those up. Now we're gonna arrange, crunch up some of the charred thyme. We're gonna arrange the tomatoes and the garlic on the platter and get ready for serving. Can you just smell it out there? Don't forget to like and subscribe, just so I can get some more subscribers. That'd be kind of fun. I guess if I did this more often, I'd get a little more subscribers. But if you know anyone, have them watch me. It'd be kind of fun. Well, I think. All right, juice. Look at that, beautiful. I'm gonna garnish it. Just some fresh parsley. Some of that charred parsley. And I'm gonna take it to the table. All right, come on in. All right, now we're gonna set up the plates. There's that spinach. We're gonna put them on top. All right. And we are ready for dinner. Let's check this, taste it, check it out.
All right, Keith, here we go.
Okay.
Give me a plate. Tomatoes, a little bit of garlic. All right.
Let's get ready. So we've got delicious sauce. So you can spoon that over your chicken and your tomatoes, even use it with your crusty bread. You've got a delicious meal. It didn't take too long. I just want to give them a taste before you go away. Let's see how the chicken came out. Oh, it's got a little steam. Oh, beautifully cooked inside. I love the charred top. So it's all about the chicken and the skin. Let's see how it tastes. Oh, and a little bit of that tomato. Perfect. Chicken thighs with roasted tomatoes and garlic. That's what's cooking with Mr. LP.